going to do a rare for me split update where I mix up Blu-rays and DVDs. I have a lot of Blu-rays to show. I haven't been doing many updates lately. So I want to get a few Blu-rays shown and a few of the Criterion DVDs that I said I was going to show. I want to get them caught up, a little bit at least. So we're going to start with the Blu-rays. First one is Roger Corman's cult classics release of Piranha. A number of people have shown this. I've been still watching a lot of people's videos. I just haven't been commenting as much. I haven't wanted to hang out in the room with the computer. Just want to watch the videos and stay up and get going. So I've seen him. But hopefully that's changing a little bit starting now. We'll see. But anyway, Piranha. Joe Dante's classic 70s Jaws semi-cash-in. Great movie. Great transfer. Actually, out of the group of stuff they've released, Galaxy of Terror, Forbidden World, all that stuff, I think maybe this and Death Race 2000 fare the best. Really cool to see it get this kind of treatment. I can't wait to see some more stuff from them in the future. Comes with the booklet, the reversible cover. Like I said, I know a lot of people have shown this already, so I won't spend too much time on it. Presented properly. I had the American one DVD for a while, and that was a joke. There was even something in the booklet about how they discussed what ratio to show it in. And they went with full screen because that's kind of what was intended. I don't believe that for a second. I didn't then, I don't now. I ended up with the UK release, which was anamorphic widescreen. Goofy cover, but pretty nice print, and I was happy with it. But now, Piranha Blu-ray. Love it. Next one, Corey Yen's DOA, Dead or Alive. Based on the video game, a lot of people refer to this as a guilty pleasure. As I've said before in other videos, I don't use that term. There is no guilt in my pleasure. I just like what I like. This movie is so much fun, I can hardly stand it. I love this movie. Had it on DVD, now I have it on Blu-ray. Looks pretty good, very colorful. Fast-moving film, lots of action. If you don't have a clue what this is, the trailer is pretty good. If you like the trailer, you'll be okay. If you don't, I don't recommend checking it out. But I like it a lot. And I'm happy to have it. Dead or Alive. Yes, there's even a volleyball scene, so can't go wrong. Next, The Incredible Hulk. The sort of reboot Hulk movie after Ang Lee's misfire. That movie's okay. I don't own it. I'm not going to ever own it. This one I like quite a bit. And I'm not a big Edward Norton fan. I know some people are. I'm not, you know, attacking anybody. I'm just saying. I'm not his biggest fan. But I thought he did really good in this movie, which surprised me. I wasn't expecting to feel that way. But good movie. Fits into the continuity of what they're trying to do. The digital copy, etc. Love the green case on this. So I finally have Iron Man. So they go together. Next comes Captain America, Thor, and eventually the Avengers. Couldn't be more excited about that. But here's the Iron Man. Another one I don't have to spend any time on, I'm sure. I must be the last person who's a fan of this movie to get this movie. But I was waiting for the price to drop. It took forever for the price to drop. After I waited a certain amount of time, there was no way I was going to back off. I was just going to wait. So I waited, finally got it. Here's Iron Man. You kind of see why I'm mixing both Blu-ray and DVD in this one, right? Because none of the Blu-rays I really need to talk about at length, I don't think. Iron Man, double disc. Beautiful, beautiful Blu-ray. Great movie. Can't wait for the stuff that's coming next. Okay, next is the action double feature, Kelly's Heroes plus Where Eagles Dare. I was very tempted. Exploited had an import of this. And I was very close to picking this up, but it was pretty expensive, and it was the theatrical cut. I'm glad I waited, because this double came out. It's a great price. They look very good. Very solid transfers. And I love both movies. I mean, Kelly's Heroes, come on. Donald Sutherland doing his world's first hippie thing in World War II. That's classic. Not too much in the way of extras. Where Eagles Dare has a vintage featurette on location thing, and they both have the trailers. Like, they look good. Very happy with them. And there they are, both discs. Great stuff. Last Blu-ray for this video is a biggie. It's the Evil Dead. Evil Dead makes its premiere on high definition, and wow. I was nervous. Some of the Anchor Bay stuff, not the best. I was a little concerned, but this is one of their big go-to titles. And so I had hope. It's spectacular. Truly beautiful, again, the way, I mean, like it never has been before, actually. And this is a limited edition, includes bonus special features DVD, limited edition. It won't be the last edition, we all know that, but it might be my last edition. It's great. It's fantastic. I have really no complaints. The first disc has an all-new commentary with Bruce Campbell, Sam Raimi, and Robert Tapert. And I think that's it. Yep, that's it. And the DVD, the second disc, has a whole lot of extras, most of which are going to be familiar to people who bought this over and over and over again. The movie is presented in the original 133, or the newer forced, cropped, blown up, however you want to refer to it, version 1.85. And it's just beautiful. It's beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. I can't overstate it enough. If you're a fan, if you've been wondering, it's worth it. Pick it up. They did a great job. Just for the color correction alone would be enough. There's so much they did right. It's fantastic. It definitely won't be the last edition, of course, but it's worth it. This is another one of those movies. I saw it in theaters several times thanks to an accommodating neighbor. I had the Thorn EMI clamshell, still have that for sentimental reasons. It was a very early tape in my collection. Had the Japanese Laserdisc, had the American Laserdisc, then had the Elite DVD, then a bunch of the Anchor Bay DVDs, etc. Now this. Hopefully, done. But we'll see. We'll see what they do next. It's the original art down there in the corner. That original theatrical poster is one of my favorite posters. I love that image. I don't have that poster, but I have the tape and a bunch of the DVDs, so highly recommend it. And now I'm going to talk about some of those Criterion DVDs I picked up during the Barnes & Noble sale. Studio Canal, Criterion lost a lot of licenses. There were still a bunch I didn't have. So I wanted to get them quickly before it became next to impossible to get them. And I picked up a bunch. There were some I already had, some I wasn't interested in. These were the ones that were really outstanding. There's still some Studio Canal titles that they have that have not been pulled yet. I don't know if they will be. I don't know if they won't be. I don't know what's going on at all. All I know is there's been two separate waves of Studio Canal titles that have been pulled, and I wasn't going to take a risk. But I think all the ones I'm going to show in this video are actually out of print. Yeah, I think they are. Okay, this one's gonna be rough on me. I'll do my best here. This is this is called Yeah, here's the title. Now, I'm not a huge Clouseau fan. I don't know, it's not that I'm not a fan, I just don't know a lot of his work. I think this is like the third film I've seen from him. And it was fantastic. This was made in the 40s. Yeah, 1947. And it surprised me in a lot of ways because of that. It's pretty frank. Yeah, well, look at the disc. Oh, this guy looks a little bit like Bob Newhart after a hard, hard weekend. Kind of a character drama, procedural, very intense, very interesting. I really enjoyed it, and I'm glad I got it. Try this again. Touche Pas Al Grisby. It's a crime film, I think a great crime film, a lot of special features, interesting stuff. The kind of story where a guy makes the big hit, he's about ready to get out of the life, things happen, the title translates into hands off the loot. So there's a lot that goes wrong for him. Comes with a booklet, a lot of extras. Excellent movie. Fantastic. I really, really enjoyed this. This is one I had not seen, but I was always interested in. It was on my to-get list. A lot of you guys have been watching my videos for a long time know that a long time ago, I quit buying standard definition Criterion because of their statements about their full commitment to Blu-ray, but when they're going to lose titles, yeah, I'm not going to take the risk. Next one, Bob Le Flambeur. Amazing Jean-Pierre Melville movie. He's a great director. I like a lot of his movies. This is no exception. Fantastic, ironic, intense movie. Watching his character, I don't want to say too much. You know, going through this movie, I realized that this is going to be one that really is all about repeat viewings. It's going to hold up and maybe even get better as it goes. So, excellent, excellent film. Some extras, the book, the usual Criterion treatment. That's Bob. Now, this one is not a crime film. From the director of Grisby, Le Trau. Very cool prison movie. Actually one of my favorites in that genre. And it took me a long time to get it. It took it being a Studio Canal movie and me getting all nervous and it going out of print for me to go after it. The booklet. And it's fantastic. I recommend all these if you're into these kind of movies at all. They're all exemplary examples of the genre. If you're into prison, escape, survival kind of movies, this one for sure. Le Trau translates into The Hole, I believe. Correct me if I'm wrong. And yeah, it's great. I wish I could talk a little more in detail about these, but I want to get all of them shown that I set aside. Now this one is not Studio Canal. It is Criterion. I just got it because I was making a pretty big Criterion order. I've wanted this movie since before I stopped buying the standard ones. That big sale and that big order, this was my excuse to just buy it. And that's Ozu's Good Morning. I just have wanted this for so long. And yeah, I just bought it. If it comes out on Blu, great. I'll buy it. I'll have no problems buying it. But who knows when that's going to happen. I know in the UK, some Ozu films have already come out on Blu. BFI collection, I believe. But yeah, they're region locked. And I'll just keep waiting. But I got it. I love it. I absolutely love it. It's not really representative of Ozu overall, but it's great, and it's light in a lot of ways. But there's a lot going on, and a lot of commentary. So that's Good Morning. They want a TV, these kids, real bad, and they go on a silence strike over it. So, yeah, Good Morning. Even better than I hoped. Even better than I hoped. I wanted that for a long time. And I'm going to stop there. There's more Criterions to show. There's more Blues to show. I'm going to try and get back into regular updating. For everybody who's written me, some of you have written with concern. And don't be concerned. It's just summer. And last summer, I kind of fought against it. This summer, I didn't so much. I just sort of went ghost. And hopefully, it'll start turning around now. So, take it easy, guys. Thanks to everybody who's subscribed and who rates and comments and writes. I really appreciate it. It's fantastic. I love it. And I'm looking forward to getting back into it regularly. So, take it easy. I'll see you next time. Later.
What's going on inside?